Hi friends, welcome to another great day of Sunday school. You know, last week was so amazing that you chose to spend Easter here with us, and I had so much fun learning about how Jesus rose from the dead on the third day to provide a way for our sins to be forgiven. But you know, the stories don't end with Jesus raising from the dead. Today we get to learn about what he did after that, how he taught people and showed people that he wasn't dead but alive. You know, let's go ahead and start learning by learning the first thing we always learn together, and that's our verse for the day. Today's verse is John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. So let's say that together. It's kind of long, but this verse is amazing. So let's go in 3, 2, 1. John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Isn't that such good news? And it shows how much God loves us, that he was willing to give his only Son as the way for our sins to be forgiven. And it also shows how important it is to believe and follow in Jesus, that Jesus really is God's plan to helping us have a relationship with him. So before we go any further, let's go ahead and let's go straight to Miss Lindy's library and let's learn more about our story and more about what Jesus did after Easter. I'll see you guys in just a minute.
Hi, I'm happy to see you. I want to show you something special. Look what my friend made for me. It's a friendship bracelet. My friend used all my favorite colors, and it's just the right size. I love my friend. We like to go places together, talk, and have fun. You probably like to do those things with your friends, too. Today's Bible story is about two friends who spent time together and talked too. Listen to hear what happened one day as they walked along a road. Two men walked along the road from Jerusalem to a village called Emmaus. It was a very long walk. As the men walked, they talked and argued about all that had happened to Jesus. It had been 3 days since Jesus died on the cross and was buried. While they were discussing and arguing, Jesus began to walk along with them. Wow! Jesus joined the two friends and walked with them down the road. The friends didn't know that the man was Jesus. Jesus asked the men what they were talking about. One of the men was named Cleopas. Cleopas was surprised that the man did not know what had happened to Jesus. Cleopas asked the man, "Are you the only person in Jerusalem who doesn't know what happened?" Jesus asked them what had happened. The men said, "Jesus taught about God and did amazing things. Some leaders took Jesus and he died on a cross. We are sad because we thought Jesus was the Savior. Now we don't know what to think. This morning, some women went to Jesus' tomb, but it was empty. The women said an angel told them that Jesus is alive." Jesus talked with the two men. He told them about God's promises and things God said would happen. When they came near Emmaus, the two men asked Jesus to stay with them. It had been a long walk, and it was almost nighttime. The two men still did not know that they were with Jesus. Jesus agreed to stay with them, and they sat down to eat. Jesus took the bread, blessed, and broke it, and gave it to them. Then they recognized him, but he disappeared from their sight. Suddenly, the two men knew that the man they had walked and talked with was Jesus. They were so excited that they hurried all the way back to Jerusalem and told Jesus' helpers what had happened. people saw that Jesus is alive. The men could not wait to tell what they saw. They walked all the way back to Jerusalem to tell the good news that Jesus is alive. The two friends hurried to tell what they knew about Jesus. We can tell what we know about Jesus too. You know lots of things about Jesus. You can tell that Jesus is God's son. You can tell that Jesus loves people. You can tell that Jesus is alive. Thanks for coming today. I'm glad that I was able to tell you what I know about Jesus. Let's visit together again very soon.
Hi friends, welcome back from Miss Lenny's Library. Wasn't that so fun learning the story together? You know, it's amazing that two disciples saw Jesus, but he didn't let them recognize him. He wanted to talk to them and understand what they were feeling and thinking about all that was happening. But as soon as he showed who he was, they were amazed and astonished because they, just like us, learned our life point for today. And our life point is that people can tell that Jesus is alive. Let's say that together. 3, 2, 1. People can tell that Jesus is alive. You know, the disciples on the road, once they knew it was Jesus, they could tell that it was not only him, but that he was alive. He wasn't a ghost or spirit, but he was still God in human flesh. He was a man, and they could tell that he was living. They could see the scars on his wrist and side, and they knew it was him and that he was alive. And that's really important, because when Jesus rose from the dead, he made a way for our sins to be forgiven. And so it's important that people could tell he was alive. You know, our Jesus point for today is that people saw that Jesus is alive. It wasn't that once he died, he disappeared forever. No. Or when he rose again, he disappeared forever. No. He walked the earth with people after he had risen from the dead, and people saw that he was living. And that is so important to knowing the good news of Jesus and the way that he provides for the forgiveness of our sins. You know, I had so much fun last week in Easter, and learning this story is even more amazing, that Jesus is still alive. You know, pretty soon our bell is going to sound, and we're going to stand to our feet and worship, but I just want us to take a second, and we're going to pray together. And I want to pray and thank God that he sent his only son, Jesus, to save us from our sins. Can you all bow your heads and close your eyes with me? Let's pray together. God, thank you so much for today and this chance we get to worship you and honor you with our actions and choices and the way that we learn. God, I just pray that you would help us to remember that Jesus, he didn't stay dead. He rose from the dead and he was alive, and people saw that he was alive. Help us to share the good news about Jesus just like his disciples did. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, can you help me listen for the bell so that we can worship together? Let's see. Where is that sound? Wait, did you hear that? There it was. That means it is time to worship together. So let's stand to our feet and get ready to move and have so much fun singing to Jesus. I'll see you guys after the song.
Amen.
welcome back from worship. Wasn't that so fun singing and dancing together? I had such a great time. I hope you did too. You know, our time is almost over for today, but I've had so much fun learning these new stories with you and this new lesson about how Jesus was still alive and people saw him. You know, let's go ahead and remember what our verse for the day was. It's John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Let's say that together. 3, 2, 1. John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Man, that is such good news, isn't it? That God loves us so much, and that verse shows us how important Jesus is for us being forgiven and having a right relationship with God. You know, our life point today that we learned from our story is that people can tell that Jesus is alive. Can you say that with me? 3, 2, 1. People can tell that Jesus is alive. Just like in our story, those two men, once they knew it was Jesus, they could tell that he was living and that he was alive. That he wasn't a spirit or a ghost, but he was a man that was standing there with them. They could see the scars and they knew it was him. Which, that helps us know what our Jesus point is. And that's that people saw that Jesus is alive. So let's say that together too. 3, 2, 1. People saw that Jesus is alive. And that's important that people saw him. They didn't just hear about him being alive or raising from the dead, but with their own eyes, they saw that Jesus was alive. Man, I've had so much fun learning all these new things with you, and I cannot wait to see you again soon. I hope you have a great rest of your week, and I hope you continue to be excited about learning more about Jesus. Bye, everyone.